Jasmine Crockett slams MTG after insulting her appearance. Did you see it? If not, here it is.
I'd like to know if any of the Democrats on this committee are employing Judge Marchand's daughter.
Please tell me what that has to do with Merrick Garland.
Is she a porn star?
Oh, Goldman. That's right. He's advising. Okay.
He's advising who? What? Do you know what we're here for? You know we're here about AG.
I don't think you know what you're here for.
Well, you the one talking about. I
think your fake eyelashes are messing up.
No, ain't nothing.
Hold on.
Order,
Mr. Chairman.
That's beneath even
you. Order, point of order of your committee.
Order.
I do have a point of order, and I would like to move to take down Ms. Green's words. That is absolutely unacceptable. How dare you attack the physical appearance of another person?
Are your feelings hurt?
Move her words down.
Aww.
Oh, girl, baby girl.
Oh, really?
Don't even play,
baby girl.
We are going to move, and we're going to take your words down.
I second that motion.
So who will have to fail? Okay. Ms. Green agrees to strike her words.
I believe she needs to apologize. No.
Perry, okay, hold on. Then after Mr. Perry's going to be recognized, then Ms. Green.
I'm not apologizing.
Well, then,
okay, reserve the right to object.
Perry,
I am Mr. not Perry. Apologizing.
Now let's go. Come on, guys.
Why don't you debate me?
Mr. Chairman, the minority.
It's pretty self-evident.
You don't have enough intelligence.
Your chair recognizes Mr. Perry.
Okay, move to strike
I'd like
the.
To strike I
move
to strike those
the
words
ladies'
as well.
Words.
I would like
strike,
order.
The ladies'
well.
Words again.
That's two requests to strike.
Oh, they cannot take the
words. There's another motion to strike her words again. Please get your members under control.
Here's the correct apology, Ms. Green. Do you ask unanimous do you agree to unanimous consent to strike your words?
I repeat again for the second time. Yes, I'll strike my words, but I'm not apologizing.
Without objection.
Mr. Chair, point of order.
Who's?
It's me.
Ms. Crockett.
I'm just curious, just to better understand your ruling, if someone on this committee then starts talking about somebody's bleach blonde, bad built butch body, that would not be engaging in personalities, correct?
A what now?
Chairman, I make a motion to strike those words.
I don't think that's
Hold
a
on.
Parliament.
I'm trying to find clarification on what quality.
Chairman,
motion to strike those words.
I have no idea what you just said.
We're not gonna do this. Look, you guys earlier literally just
you just voted to do
y'all
it.
Did it first, so
I'm
you
trying
don't
to get voted to do it.
Order.
I'm trying to get clarification.
Look, calm down.
No, because this is what y'all do. So I'm trying to get
Ms. Crockett, you're not recognized. Ms. Crockett.
I can't hear you with your
and
yelling.
You don't want me
calm
to
down.
Be,
no. Can you please calm
don't
down?
Don't tell me to calm down.
Calm down.
Because y'all talk
calm
noise,
down.
And then you
you're
can't
out of
take
control.
Because if I,
Look,
come,
Chairman,
if I
can
come
we
and talk about her, y'all going to have a problem.
With millions watching and many people benefiting from this program called Indisputable, we just need 1% of the viewers to become a paid member so we can continue to bring this content to you. Now back to the show.
So we have to dissect it. All right, we've got to identify voices. In some cases, for those wondering, it was Republican Representative Anna Paulina Luna who called her colleague Jasmine Crockett, quote, out of control. All right, now every black woman in the workplace understands that. You throw stones, you act out of order. And then you hide. I mean, you throw the stones, you hide, and then tell a black woman, you're out of control. Calm down. You need to calm down. You're scaring everybody. Okay, that's, by now you know, right? You know. We all know what it is. All right, so following the incident, Jasmine Crockett would post on X saying, well, a lot, and doubling down, if you will. I have time today, I think some call it. Are they still saying that? So MTG wanted to talk about my appearance in committee. It's against the rules to do. She refused to apologize. The chairman ruled that it was okay. I'm not even sure the chairman knew what day of the week it was. I mean, they just walked all over him. And I asked for clarification about what qualifies as engaging in personalities. And basically wanted to know if I could talk about her appearance as well. Y'all know what she looks like, right? Okay. People in glass houses, this is what happens when mentally deficient people who can't read and follow rules or just don't give a damn somehow end up in Congress. That's on X. It's still up if you want to go look at it yourself. All right, here's Greene's post following the incident, okay? Some people are upset about the scene from Oversight Committee last night. Well, I'm upset and disgusted pretty much every day. The Democratic-controlled DOJ, federal government, and Congress in general. The Democrats are the same people who voted to kill unborn babies up until the day of birth. And they would march us all in front of a firing squad if they could. Congress has enslaved the American people in over $34 trillion in debt. That will be over $55 trillion in only 10 years. Marjorie Taylor Greene on X. Okay, so now Senator John Fetterman steps into the ring, if you will, weighing in on the incident. They all got a piece of this. What's that thing on Friday night that the wrestlers have? Do you know, Jackson, is it tag team, main event or something? Do you know what I'm talking about? Where they all get a piece of it. Yeah, they all jump in. And then sometimes they tap out if someone's tired and the other guy, the partner or woman, jumps in. So here's Fetterman. Yeah, that's how it works. And this is what's going on in Congress. Okay, your tax dollars hard at work. In the past, I've described the U.S. House as the Jerry Springer Show. Today, I'm apologizing to the Jerry Springer Show. Okay. AOC, not to be outdone, would respond to Fetterman's tweet with, I understand you likely would not have stood up for your colleague and seem to be confused about racism and misogyny being a both sides issue, but I stand up to bullies instead of becoming one. And to the women of Pennsylvania, I'd stand up for you too. Enjoy your Friday. All right now. That's like, you know, saying, and take care. All right, have a good one. I'll see you next time. Okay? That meant she's done. She's spoken. I love some AOC. Jackson, I first want to dissect the initial, as I said, this is rooted in white privilege. You throw stones, you make an attack, and then you duck and hide. You double down. And when a woman of color says, not today, you're not fitting to come at me that way. Oh, ma'am. It's, oh my goodness, clutching pearls and the like. Am I wrong about this? And that's a rhetorical question, by the way.
No, I mean, you're definitely not wrong about that in terms of, you know, just kind of the general culture, especially that you would see like in corporate America. And I know that you have a lot of experience with that. And we're still working to change things along those lines. But there's a lot to say about this exchange. For one thing, I mean, you got to love it a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Like to see, I always love Jasmine Crockett. She just, got that fire in her. You know what I'm saying? And but also too, like you could definitely critique this and say that they were being a bit ridiculous. But on the other hand, you know, like just go overseas to Britain and their parliament, they get down, they go crazy. So this was nothing compared to that. So, I mean, I guess there's not too much to be hung up on because, like, what are they doing otherwise? Yeah. Like, they may have this back and forth, but it's not like they're passing a whole bunch of laws. I mean, in the House, they pass more things, but oftentimes that's just, you know, a show job because they know ain't nothing going to go down in the Senate. I think we're in the middle of one of our most unproductive sessions of Congress that we've ever had.
Yeah, I think you're right.
But lastly, Marjorie Taylor Greene, I think that she doesn't really know how to do much of anything else. This is how she got where she is. And so just kind of being provocative is all she's ever going to do. And as long as her district wants her in office, then she's going to be there. Unless they change their hearts and minds about her, then we're going to continue to see this. But she crazy for sure. She is.
She is like, you ever have an infestation of fruit flies?
Yeah, they're just there.
Yeah, you had bananas. You went on a trip. And when you came home, you said, oh, my goodness, you kill one, there's more. And they keep coming and coming and coming, even after you've thrown out the rotten bananas. Okay, fruit flies are the most annoying things ever. And they're just always around doing their own thing. And that's Marjorie Taylor Greene. Mm-hmm. And you're right. She's here to stay unless the good people of Georgia, I'm in this state, decide that they want to run another candidate. I know somebody else who's here in Georgia when he's not touring. And I don't know why he won't run against her. If this is what we're doing in Congress, okay? Mm-hmm. He, you know, and he's got the name recognition. He had it even before Club Shay Shay, but I say Cat Williams for Congress. if this is what you want to do, we might as well do it the Cat Williams way, okay?
Yeah.
Hugely intelligent, going to get things done. When he speaks, people listen, and they change course sometimes. And I think I'm just throwing it out there. I don't know if he has the time, the energy, the will, but I think that that's respectful. How about Fetterman? Because I too have a problem. Like I said, we all see it. You know who started it? I expect better of both of you is what he's saying. This is beneath me. Okay, and maybe it is. Says the man in the hooded sweatshirt. Okay, this is beneath us. You lack decorum.
That's actually a decent point that you just made.
Right. It's like, stop the good people on both teams played hard. That's not really, if you're going to enter the fray, then let's break it all the way down. And we don't need you preaching about a girl fight. That's really what he was saying. Oh, look at them, as if it's beneath him. If this is what Congress is doing, well, then let's go all the way and let's get into it. What say you about Fetterman's tweet? X, whatever.
Right, now X. And now it's perfect because like when you finish reading Marjorie Taylor Greene, it's like Marjorie Taylor Greene on X. It's just so stupid and it sounds perfect because. But like I said, that actually was an interesting point that you pointed out about John Fetterman kind of never being up to dress code like pretty much everyone else is talking about decorum. And I know you weren't like really nitpicking at it, but if we're going to talk about it, then there's other things to discuss. But when it comes to John Fetterman, at this point, honestly, I'm really not interested in him.
Maybe that's why he did it.
Yeah, that's just kind of where I'm at with him now. It's just like, whatever. You know, he's a major disappointment. But it was interesting to watch, like when Jasmine Crockett started throwing those similar insults back, it kind of looked like she was thinking about it for a minute. You know what I'm saying? Because if this is where we're at now, but yeah, it is where we're at. I mean, Donald Trump may be president again. So it's absolutely where we're at right now.
This is what we're doing. Did you hear me? Okay. Mm-hmm. And so that's what we're doing. I find the whole thing disgusting, but when you vote certain people in who have an agenda of just putting the brakes on everything and tearing the house down and throwing gasoline and where's my lighter? Well, then this is what you're going to get. And when checks stop and services stop and taxes, a lot of that's already gone on. Well, we'll see. I'll say it again. Kat, can you hear me? Kat Williams, I'll work for the campaign. Okay, because that's a smart brother right there.